The iteration pattern is super helpful. Let's look at how drawing dots of increasing size use the iteration pattern. Here I have a script that draws these dots of increasing size. I also have two scripts that use the iteration pattern. The one on the left counts from 10 to 0. Let's watch. The one on the right plays the notes from 60 to 69. These both use the iteration pattern because they both set a variable, used a repeat. Within that repeat, they both changed that variable, and then they both had a block like this one where they used that variable. The script on the left said the value of the variable my number, and the script on the right used the variable by playing the note my note. The script for drawing dots of increasing size looks pretty different, but it actually has the same structure. Let's compare it to this one. First, we set the pen size to 1. So that's really similar. We're setting a variable. Here it's pen size to 1. We have a repeat. That looks good. Let's look if we ever change that variable. Here we have a line that says change pen size by 5. So within the loop, we're changing that variable. Let's look at how we're using that variable. On the right, we played a note, my note. But here, just think about how pen down depends upon the size of the pen. So actually by doing pen down and drawing a dot there, we're using that variable. So this has all of the pieces of the iteration pattern. We set a variable, we have a repeat, we change that variable, and here with the pen down, we use that variable. Seeing how this is an example of the pattern hopefully helps you better understand this script and helps you better understand how to apply this pattern to new scripts.